Good day, buddies. Before we proceed, let's first meet my praying mantis I named Ant. Isn't she gorgeous? No, 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 she's not a feeder to my ants. Cause she's one of them and also my pet. That's why I named her Ant. So that she can relate with them even if just their names. Anyway, she's almost 2 weeks now under my care. She's so green back then. Now, her back limbs slowly turning brown. As a result of her camouflage maybe in the driftwood, where she's staying most of the time. And also she's so tiny the first day. But, after molting twice since then, look at how big she groaned. I'll be making contents about her soon. Stay tuned and welcome to DColony. Lastly, before proceeding with our DIY, let's meet another guest. Let's welcome my new Camponitus colony. I caught their queen last June 25th. But, I labeled her as an infertile queen, cause she's eating her eggs in her first 2 weeks. But luckily, it's just her preparation for the upcoming weeks. The colony is 2 months and 2 weeks old on this video. They currently have 8 workers. Anyway guys, they are Camponitus variegatus colony. Aren't they so good looking? Let's give them some food. Buddies, if you have a queen ant that has been eating her eggs, don't give up to them too early. Even though most of the queen doing that is infertile, but there's still a chance that maybe they're just the same with this queen. Moving on, I bought a mini ant farm for my new ant colony at a local store, which we will be using for today's formicarium customization episode of the channel. First, let's cut some guide. I'm using Sintra board here, but you can also use cardboard. This will block our barrier area, so we can still have a smooth area for our chosen ant barrier. Next thing we need is some stones for the background. Let's just find the best spot for them, so that we can just easily place them later. Before proceeding to the next step, don't forget to block the nest entrance first. We can now mix grout and water. In case you need a more detailed grout mixing for this project, you can watch this DIY video here on the iCard. After having the right mixture, we can now pour the grout inside. We'll just apply it evenly, before placing the stones to their spots. Then we will add some artificial plants for more color. And also cut a driftwood to fit inside the formicarium. We can now set it aside to dry for 24 hours. We just need to trim the sharp edges here, for a better look. For the flooring, we can use artificial grass or natural sand. We will try them both, but we will go for the sand flooring first. Just apply a thin layer of it, in the base. Add a tiny driftwood. And we now have a desert-looking ant farm. Next is, using this artificial grass for our second look. We will just cut it, and put the grass carpet inside. Place the driftwood back. And simple as that, we now have a grassland theme formicarium. I will not yet move my Camponitus variegatus colony here, buddies. Cause it's still too early for them to have an ant farm. I'm just too excited to make this episode for the channel. I will let you know if happens I move them, or another ant colony here, in our customized formicarium. I just hope you have learned something from this video, guys. Be a genie for the first time, by granting my wish and tapping the like and share button, that would help a lot. This is DColony. Saying goodbye. For now. But hoping to see you on my next videos.